JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for January the 19th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It lost the most ground against the Canadian dollar, the Aussie, SEK and NOK, while it underperformed the least versus the Swiss franc. The greenback gained only against the Japanese yen. Now, the weakening of the safe havens dollar, yen and franc, combined with the strengthening of the commodity-linked loonie and Aussie, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU indices closed in positive territory, with the only exception being UK's FTSE 100, which slid 0.22%. Wall Street stayed closed for Martin Luther King Day. Risk appetite was boosted even more during the Asian trading today. Although China's Shanghai Composite fell 0.83%, Japan's Nikkei, Hong Kong's Hang Seng and South Korea's KOSPI gained 1.39, 1.96 and 2.61% respectively. With no clear catalyst behind the moves, we believe that markets traded in the direction of their broader trends. All this is in tandem with our broader view. It's been some time now that we've been calling for higher equities and other risk-linked assets. We stick to our guns that the vaccinations, the fiscal stimulus in the US, the monetary policy support around the world, and the softer stance on trade by Biden are a cocktail of developments which is likely to keep risk appetite supported in the first months of 2021. Having said that, though, we believe that investors will adopt a more cautious stance today and tomorrow ahead of Joe Biden's inauguration as the 46th US president. Usually such events pass unnoticed by the markets, as the election outcome and who will be the next president is already known. However, this time there is the risk for Trump's supporters to proceed with more violent protests, as they still refuse to accept that the outcome of the elections was fair and clear. In such a case, a risk of wave may be possible, resulting in corrective moves in most markets. Now back to the currencies. Pound traders are likely to pay some attention to the UK CPIs for December, which are scheduled to be released tomorrow during the early European morning. Both the headline and core rates are expected to have risen to 0.5 and 1.3% year over year from 0.3 and 1.1% respectively. Although this is a move in the desired direction, both rates are still decently below the Bank of England's target of 2%, and thus the prospect of the bank increasing the pace of its QE purchases at some point soon is not off the table. In any case, this is something the bank already noted that it stands ready to do, thus it will not come as a major surprise if it happens. Overall, with the Brexit saga now taking the back seat and Bank of England governor playing down the prospect of negative interest rates, the pound has the potential to perform relatively well, at least against the safe havens like the dollar and the yen, which we expect to stay under selling interest due to a supported overall market sentiment. We understand that talks between the EU and the UK are far from over, as there is still the issue of the UK's access to the EU's financial world. However, we will start worrying again as soon as headlines on that front start entering the spotlight. Now, as for today's events, during the European session, the final German CPIs for December, the nation's ZEW survey for January, and Eurozone's current account balance for November are due to be released. As it is always the case, the final German CPIs are forecast to confirm their preliminary estimates, while with regards to the ZEW survey, the current conditions index is expected to have declined to minus 68 from minus 66.5, but the economic sentiment one is expected to have risen to 60 from 55. There is no forecast for Eurozone's current account balance. Later in the day, we get Canada's manufacturing sales for November, which are expected to have slipped 0.1% month over month after rising 0.3% in October. We also have a speaker on today's agenda, and this is Bank of England Chief Economist Andy Haldane. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.